Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel and to this week's video. So today we'll talk about default judgments. And just to say that today's video was inspired by a MoneyWeb article that a friend of mine shared with me over the weekend. And I'll put a link in the description below this video to a copy of the article so you can read it if you are interested. But basically this article was about how a company recently obtained a default judgment against the Emfuleni municipality up in Gauteng. Now that in itself, of course, is not significant, but what is significant is the fact that, as is mentioned in the article, this must be the biggest default judgment ever granted by a South African court. And the value of this default judgment was for 492 million rand. Now that's close to half a billion rand default judgment. And that is quite significant, guys. Now that made me think that it might be a good idea this week to briefly chat to you about default judgments. Now, firstly, what is a default judgment? Now, a default judgment is basically a judgment that a plaintiff in legal proceedings can obtain very early on in the process against the defendant simply by virtue of the fact that the defendant has failed to take certain steps in the process. Now, what are these steps? Firstly, when a defendant in legal proceedings fails to timely file a notice of intention to defend, or where a notice of intention to defend is filed, but the defendant fails to deliver its plea and has been barred from doing so, then the plaintiff can approach the court and ask for default judgment to be granted in its favor. Now, the important point to make here is this is very early on in the process, and so this is a speedy way by which a plaintiff can obtain default judgment against the defendant. Now, the next question is, how does a plaintiff go about obtaining default judgment against such a defendant? Now, I'm going to talk about the situation where the defendant has failed to file a notice of intention to defend, because that is the one we see mostly in practice. Now, imagine the process is this. When a plaintiff has a claim against a defendant, the plaintiff will usually, through its attorneys, have a summons prepared and issued out of the relevant court. That summons will then go to the sheriff, and the sheriff will serve a copy of that summons on the defendant. Now, then the sheriff will issue a return of service, and the return of service will basically be proof of the fact of service, and it will contain all the relevant details as to how and when the court process was served on the defendant. Now, importantly, the defendant has usually 10 days from the date of service to file a notice of intention to defend. And if the defendant fails to do that, this is when the plaintiff can now go back to the court on application and in writing make mention of the fact that a summons was served and produced the, or summons was issued and produced the original summons, that the summons was served on the defendant and produced as proof thereof the sheriff's return of service. And then finally, that the due date by when the defendant had to file the notice of intention to defend was on whatever the date may have been. And then finally, that the defendant has failed to file the notice of intention to defend timely, and accordingly, the plaintiff now asks for default judgment against the defendant. Now, that's normally what the application looks like. And in the High Court, the registrar can grant default judgment, or in the Magistrates Court, the clerk of the court can grant default judgment in favor of the plaintiff. But just to note that sometimes it might be necessary for that application to be referred either to the judge if it's High Court, or to the magistrates if it's Magistrates Court. Now that we know how a plaintiff can go about obtaining default judgment, what can a defendant do if a default judgment has been granted against it? Now, the first point to make here is that a defendant must act swiftly as soon as the defendant becomes aware of the fact that a default judgment has been granted against it. Because in certain circumstances, there might be grounds upon which the defendant can approach the court to have the default judgment rescinded or varied, but the defendant must act swiftly. So the best advice I can give you is to seek legal advice as soon as you become aware that a default judgment has been granted against the defendant. Now, guys, that's basically how default judgments work in practice. I hope you now have a better understanding of it, and I hope now you don't get caught like the Imfuleni municipality got caught. And I also hope you can see why it's fascinating that a default judgment of close to half a billion rand can be granted against the municipality. But be that as it may, guys, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you back here next week. And until then, take care and cheers for now.